Hello there, all you beautiful thrill seekers. My name is Ghost Shadonk Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to Ghost Chat YouTube channel.
It feeds on adrenaline. The 18 story drop. The angry boomerang. The wretched corkscrew. Unholy triple loop. Introducing Viper. Pound for pound, the most frightening roller coaster on Earth.
Hello there, guys. My name is Ghost Shadonk Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a theme park newsroom discussion video, where in this video, we're going to be looking at what could replace Viper at Six Flags Magic Mountain in the long-term future. Now, I think every coaster enthusiast in America, or most coaster enthusiasts in the States and around the world, probably think that further down the line, in the next 5, 10, 15 years, Viper could go. And I'm one of them. I definitely think that Viper could go in the next 5, 10, 15 years. Maybe even 20 years if they wanted to. And especially with the RMC Raptor opening probably around 2021, 2022 probably, in the Green Lantern First Flight and Tidal Wave site, I think it'd be important to look at potential replacement types for the Viper roller coaster, especially since an RMC Raptor, a Jersey Devil type RMC Raptor coaster, was actually one of my predictions from earlier on in the years for the replacement for the Viper. I think that would work on that site really well, but now they've got it somewhere else in the park for the next year or two. It's going to be interesting to sort of predict potential ride types to replace it, you know, instead. So leave your predictions in the comments down below. I'd love to reply to every single comment, as I always do. You know I do. But for now, guys, make sure you like the video if you've loved it. Make sure you comment down below your thoughts and opinions on this. Subscribe to the channel. Click the notification bell so you never miss any other news, reviews, discussions, predictions, interviews, and much, much more, including vlogs when the parks open again. Also, guys, if you go in the description down below, not only will you find a link to submit your video ideas, Google Forms, and also the Discord server where you, that's right, you, can be part of the Coaster Shell fanbase and interact with me. Also, guys, you can find links to Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, and Snapchat. And if you go over to the community page, you can see that we've got a link to the ATU Awards, the Alton Towers Updates Awards. The closing date is January 7th for votes. I've been nominated for Favourite Enthusiast to post good content throughout, and Favourite Theme Park Enthusiast, which in my opinion is the big award. So a massive thank you to everyone who's voted so far. And if you still want to vote, the link's in the community page, the recent post over the last day or so on the community page. And for now, guys, before we take a look at potential replacements for the Viper, let's have a little look at the history of this classic Arrow Looper while we put the Google Maps image on your screen right about now. Fandabby-dozy, the image is on your screen while you look at the site. Let's have a look at the history behind the ride. So, this ride opened back on the 7th of April, 1990. God, it feels like a while ago now. It's a custom looping coaster by Aerodynamics. There's loads of these rides elsewhere. 24, one of them relocated. Here's a few examples for you. Anaconda at King's Dominion, Carolina Cyclone at Carowinds, Corkscrew at Cedar Point and Valley Fair, Demon at Six Flags Great America, and California's Great America. So two America parks. Two Great America parks. Well, hey. there's some defunct ones as well. Drakenfire at Busch Gardens Williamsburg. The Great American Scream Machine at Six Flags Great Adventure. Orient Express at Worlds of Fun. Shockwave at Six Flags Great America. So there's quite a few examples of the Arrow Custom Looping Coaster, and one of the currently existing ones is, of course, Viper at Six Flags Magic Mountain. Now, this has a length of 3,830 feet, a height of 188 feet, a drop of 171 feet, it's a massive coaster, a speed at 70 miles per hour max, 7 inversions in a 2 minute 30 ride duration. It's got a 144 foot tall loop, a 90 foot tall loop, a 62 foot tall loop, a 40 foot tall double corkscrew, and a Batwing, just to name a few special elements. It cost $8 million, according to Rollercoaster Database, with a capacity of 1,700 riders per hour. So that is a little bit of stats and a little bit of history on the Viper. Now, as you already see the Google Maps image all the way through those reports and the stats, you can see it's a massive, massive site. You can probably see why I predicted maybe an RMC Raptor coaster a few years ago to replace the Viper. But looking at the site, there's still a couple of types of coasters that you could see replace this coaster. First up, the B&M Dive Coaster. This has been rumoured for a good couple of years to come to the park now. You look at past Cedar Fair dive coasters like Valraven at Cedar Point, Yukon Striker at Canada's Wonderland, you know, King's Island, I'm sure we'll get one at some point. but I think overall, there's a really good potential here to work with the surrounding site, and utilize the dive coaster aspects as part of the Viper's plot of land. You've got a really good possibility here to utilize the current station, build this massive, massive lift hill, do the drop, utilize the whole site, even, you know, don't even stop at just one drop and a couple of inversions. Make it the world's tallest, fastest, longest, most inverting or most looping dive coaster in the world. 6.5 Magic Mountain could break so many records with this, and there's untapped potential here. The second prediction I've got is, now I would brace yourselves for this, a B&M or an Intamin hypercoaster. Now, I know what people are going to say, why a hypercoaster? And I think I know why people will say, why a hypercoaster? One, COVID impact, and two, why not a Giga? They could go for a B&M Giga. That could be the usual route they could go down. They could utilize that entire plot of land, utilize the rest of the remaining space, the rest of the green land around the Viper, and they could really utilize the site's potential here and really create a massive Giga coaster. But what about a compact B&M Hyper? Or, if they wanted to, look at Hyperion at Energylandia. You look at how Intamin did their Hypers, and you look at Intamin, you think, well, hang on a minute. What if they could do a compact Giga coaster that works in the Hyper plot of land? Now, I could be completely insane here, but I don't think it's out of the realm of possibilities in the future for 6.5 Magic Mountain. I reckon a Giga or a Hyper by B&M or Intamin, because I'd like to see them work with Intamin again, would be fantastic fits for the park. And I think that overall, I would like to see that type of coaster work in this plot of land, and especially work around with the remaining greenland around the Viper's site. I mean, there's plenty of greenland you could work with around the Viper's site, and there's still plenty of available space you could use in and around the current Viper plot of land. So there's real potential here with the Hyper or the Giga option, just as much the dive coaster option. So there we go then, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages, that is the Viper replacement predictions I've got. Now, of course, the B&M Giga, B&M Hyper, Intamin Giga, they are all potential dream options for me personally. However, I think if I was to choose between the two, the most realistic choice I could think of is the B&M Dive Coaster. Now, if I had a bonus option, something like Taran, an Intamin multi-launch roller coaster with a spike element, with a backwards launch maybe, so along the lines of Hagrid's, but more Taran-like. So it's like the special moments of Hagrid's mixed in with a Taran-type layout. That would be a wonderful replacement for the Viper, and a nice classic launch coaster with some high elements, some low elements, low to the ground, twisting in and out, a couple of inversions here and there, multiple launches. That would be a wonderful experience as well. But I would still choose the dive coaster because I think you've got untapped potential here unlike anything else. So I wouldn't expect a Viper replacement until about 5, 10, 15 years down the line. However, I think a dive coaster is there waiting and ready to be used by 6.5 Magic Mountain. So, thank you very much guys for watching this theme park newsroom discussion video on Viper's future replacement at 6.5 Magic Mountain. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell so you never miss another thrilling YouTube video. And for now guys, my name is Coast Shell, Caitlin the Coast Life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. And that, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages, is the end of the video. Thank you very much. Have a Six Flags-tastic day.